Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example of how to find the scalar equations of a line. And the information that we're given about this problem is the point P, which is 4, 13, negative 3, and a vector 2i minus 3k. So along with this information, we're going to need the following three formulas. X equals x sub 0 plus a times t, y equals y sub 0 plus b times t, and z equals z sub 0 plus c times t. We'll get x sub 0, y sub 0, and z sub 0 from the point P. So we'll plug in 4 for x sub 0, 13 for y sub 0, and negative 3 for z sub 0, because our point is always going to come in the form x, y, z. So we'll plug in that information for these three variables here. For a, b, and c, we're going to plug in information that we get from our vector here. And we're going to leave the variable t because our scalar equations are going to be in terms of the variable t, so we leave that alone. So the first thing we're going to do is generate our three equations for x, y, and z, and then we're going to simplify if we need to. For our first equation, x, like I said, we plug in 4 here for x sub 0. For a, we're going to plug in 2, and the reason is because we have this vector here, 2i minus 3k. Normally a vector, a vector is always in terms of I, j, and k. In this case, j does not appear in the equation because we have 0j, but still remember that it's there. So the coefficient on I is what we're going to plug in for a. The coefficient on j, in this case 0, is what we'll be plugging in for B, and the coefficient on K is what we plug in for C. So remember, it's I, J, K, A, B, C. So we'll be plugging in 2 for A, 0 for B, and negative 3 for C. So in this case, A here, we're plugging in 2, the coefficient on I. So our scalar equation here for X is 4 plus 2T. For y, again, we'll plug in our y-coordinate from the point P, 13, for y sub 0. And then we'll be plugging in the coefficient on our j term in our vector for b. In this case, we don't have j in our vector, so the coefficient on it is 0. So we plug in 0 for b. For z, we'll plug in the point negative 3 for z sub 0. So we have negative 3 here. And then we're plugging in negative 3 because it's the coefficient on k, plugging that in for c. So instead of plus c, we'll end up here, since we're plugging in this negative 3, with a minus 3t. So we would be able to stop there, except that we can simplify our y equation because we don't need to leave in 0t right there. So our y equation just ends up being y equals 13. We can't really simplify any further our x or z equations. You still want to leave them with t as the second term in the equation, so we leave the constant here, and then t, the constant, and then t. So we put these three together, and together they constitute our scalar equations for this line. So we end up with x equals 4 plus 2t, y equals 13, and z equals negative 3 minus 3t. And that's our final answer. So simple as that. I hope it helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!